Welcome back to Investor Intel. I'm Peter Clausi. Today I'm here again with my friend Kirill Klip. Hi, Kirill.
Hi, Peter. How are you doing? What's good. The weather there in Toronto?
Rainy and cold. You?
It's sun and sunshine and bright sky. Quite unusual for us, so I hope to send a little bit of energy to you and all our viewers.
Good. Well, when you come up for the mining show in March, hopefully it'll be nice. We can wander around outside and talk about TNR Gold. So TNR was on my radar. Stock price has jumped up lately, and there's only one man in the world to explain this.
Thank you very much, Peter. I guess that man will be me. So I will start to tell you a little bit about our story, TNR Gold. Basically, we are building green energy metals royalty company, TNR Gold. Okay. And I will start with three very important numbers for our short conversation today. First one will be from UBS, the largest wealth management bank in the world. They estimate jumped by 2,819% in lithium demand in 100 EV world. Second very important number will be from Corp International Association. They are talking that Corp demand for electric cars should accelerate ninefold from 185,000 metric tons today to an estimated 1.7 million tons in 2027. And the third extremely important number, which later in our interview I will try to explain to all our viewers better, is $127 million. This is an estimated cash flow, undiscounted, for our TNR Gold royalty in a huge copper project being developed by McEwen Mining, right, under the management and leadership of legendary Rob McEwen, called Los Azules in Argentina.
Let's do Los Azules first because it's easy. TNR yes. Gold has a royalty on a world-famous large copper project. Is that copper project in production yet?
No, this copper project not in production yet, but this year we have received extremely important confirmation of its potential. Los Azules is one of the largest copper porphyry systems in the world. Just a few weeks ago, Argentina and Chile have signed a protocol aimed at development of Los Azules. So, check number one, political uncertainty is out from evaluation metrics for this project. This support and cooperation exhibited by Chile and Argentina for potential mine development at Los Azules comes as a very good news for us, of course, right? Because just in September, McEwen Mining has delivered new PEA for Los Azules, preliminary economic assessment, and new resources in all categories reported by McEwen Mining.
Is that the news that caused TNR stock to jump?
Yes, it took us few weeks and maybe even couple of months that market digested more or less potential of our story. And today it's such a great opportunity just before Christmas to discuss what is really happening here. And first of all, the most beautiful thing in mining which could happen is already in our news releases. Our baby Los Azules is growing much larger. Numbers are getting bigger and bigger. For example, copper resource now jumped from 19 billion pounds to almost 30 billion pounds. It's 55% increase. Gold is now up from 3.4 million ounces of gold to over 5.5 billion ounces of gold. It's another 61% increase.
So and what's the target timeline, though, to be in production?
McEwen Mining now is talking about Los Azules being in production in 5 years' time. So finally, we start to hit the numbers, major milestones, when it's moving into production, and whatever discount investment community have on our royalty,
right,
hopefully these discounts will become smaller. And I will come back to our number we just discussed a few minutes ago. What is this $127 million, which I expect to receive from Los Azules copper mine as my part of net smelter return revenue over the life of mine? For the first time, McEwen Mining has reported estimations of net smelter return and estimations for cash flow of net smelter return from Los Azules will be $35.2 billion over 36 years of life of mine undiscounted. Our part of TNR Gold applying now 0.36% NSR royalty on all this cash flow will be very interesting number, $127 million. And you can check, and maybe you better tell our viewers what is our market cap. But of course, they should always check all our disclaimers, Peter.
Absolutely. And anybody who wants to read that feasibility study can go to CDAR, where McEwen Mining would have posted that.
Exactly.
So the Los Azules Copper Project is an easy one to discuss, and that's within TNR Gold. You also have a gold porphyry project in Alaska.
Yes.
Let's talk about that. What's that one called?
That one is called Shotgun Gold. And what is very interesting, as all our mining followers know, Alaska was quite a difficult jurisdiction, unfortunately, for a number of years. But now, thanks to positive political changes in this case, and I will stop short here, Alaska is back to business. And we can see that one after another, I will not mention names, but Alaskan-based gold development companies are shooting through the roof, if I may use this kind of wording here. So basically, what we have with our shotgun gold in Alaska, we are just a couple of hundred miles apart from Donlin Gold, as you know, developed by Nova Gold, and that is very significant porphyry intrusive gold system with over 40 million ounces of gold. I have another major asset among our team at TNR Gold is Greg Johnson, our director, who was among the founders, Peter, as you remember, of Nova Gold,
yes,
and who basically developed Donlin Gold. They were developing Shotgun Gold, and then we managed to buy it out from Nova Gold when gold market, you know, was not very exciting anymore, and majors or even companies like Nova Gold, they were selling the exploration assets. And you know, I think we made one of the best investment decisions, at least in my lifetime, when we secured 100% of this project. Now we own 90%. So basically, what we're talking there, we're talking about very similar geological signature, according to Greg Johnson. All our viewers could check our news releases from years ago. And we have developed a quite interesting resource already there. It's 20 million tons at 1 gram per ton of gold. And we have 700,000 ounces of gold inferred resource initial, but it's top of the ridge. So nothing prevents us to think that this project could become another very significant gold porphyry system with intrusive mineralization in Alaska.
What's the relationship between TNR and International Lithium? Does TNR own shares in International?
Yes, very good question, Peter. TNR Gold holds a strategic stake in International Lithium, owing very significant number of shares. Plus, we have a royalty on one of the major assets in International Lithium. The project is called Mariana Lithium. It's located in Argentina, and it's operated by largest lithium material producers from China, largest lithium, Ganfeng Lithium from China. And now you can see our philosophy. Basically, we are project generation company. We are looking for opportunities. We invest in our venture capital in order to advance the project to the level when majors of this world, like McEwen Mining, like Ganfeng Lithium, will be interested in our project. And then we're reducing our operational risk, we're reducing our capital exposure, because these companies, leaders in the industry, they will bring capital and, what is more important, technology in order to advance our projects.
Right.
And then we are keeping our stake as long as we can contribute. And hopefully valuation of the project goes much higher. And then our stake will be either bought out by our operators like Ganfeng Lithium in International Lithium, for example, or we will reduce our shareholding to royalty like with Los Azules, but like we discussed, potential cash flow could be so significant in order to be applied to our recent market capitalization.
So what percentage of international lithium does TNR own?
At the moment, we own 14.2% after conversion of our convertible debt. We just recently increased it again. This fall, we bought another 5 million shares in international lithium, which we can convert after conversion at 14 cents.
And TNR holds then a net smelter returns royalty on the Marianas project, where Ganfeng is your partner.
Yes, that's correct. 1.8%, which we believe will become another very significant potential cash flow stream, like we just discussed about our Los Azules copper royalty.
Sounds good. Hey, when you come up to Toronto, I'll buy you a beer again, like last year, and we can talk about it.
Thank you very much, Peter. Thank you. It's very good energy. We both know what we're talking about, and we can continue for hours.
Sounds good. I thank you for your time. Have a tremendous day.
Thank you very much, Peter, and I would like to use this opportunity to extend the warmest regards from all our team at TNR Gold to all Investor Intel team, to you personally, and I would like to wish a very happy holidays, very happy New Year, and I will not afraid it. Merry Christmas if you're celebrating it.